गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन टू आवर इंग्लिश क्लास, क्लास नाइन्थ. इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव स्टार्टेड द लेसन नंबर 6 ऑफ द बुक मोमेंट्स वेदरिंग द स्टॉर्म इन इरसामा, रिटन बाय हर्ष मंडेर. एंड इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस द समरी, द स्टोरी आइडिया एंड द टाइटल ऑफ द स्टोरी. सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद द रीडिंग एंड एक्सप्लेनेशन पार्ट. In this story, Weathering the Storm in Irsama, it is a description of the brave acts of a courageous boy named Prashant. I'm just telling you the introduction. He guided the victims of floods who gathered at Red Cross shelter in his village in Odisha. He inspired each person of the community to help one another. This lesson tells us the importance of the young segment of the society. They can together work for the community and the society. During the natural calamities, they can help, guide and save the community with the medicines, care, material and food. The value of the young is recognized at the time of need. No doubt in it, the youth of the country is really plays a very important role in the upbringing of the society. So, in this chapter also, in this lesson also, we will read about a young boy, Prashant. And the whole story revolves around that character. So let's begin with the story. On 27th October 1999, 7 years after his mother's death, Prashant had gone to the block headquarters of Irsama, a small town in coastal Odisha, some 18 kilometers from his village, to spend the day with a friend. In the evening, a dark and menacing storm quickly gathered. Menacing means harmful. Winds beat against the houses with a speed and fury. Fury means with extreme strength that Prashant had never witnessed before. Heavy and incessant means continuous rain filled the darkness. Ancient trees were uprooted and crashed to the earth. Screams rent the air as people and houses were swiftly washed away. The angry waters swirled means move along with the whirling motion into his friend's house, neck deep. The building was of brick and mortar. Mortar means a mixture of lime, cement, sand and water used to construct building, and was strong enough to survive the devastation of the wind's velocity of 350 km per hour. But the cold terror of the family grew with the crashing of trees that had got uprooted and fallen on their house sometime in the middle of the night, damaging its roof and walls. Now see what happened in the first paragraph. We see that the Prashant was a native of a village in the coastal state of Odisha. On 27th October 1999, he was on a visit to a friend in Irsama, which is a small town in Odisha and a block headquarter in Jagatpura district. His village was at a distance of 18 kilometers from Irsama. He had lost his mother 7 years ago. That day, a strong storm gathered in the evening. Furious wind accompanied by continuous rain lashed the place. Screams could be heard as trees got uprooted and destroyed the houses as they fell on them. The water flowed with gush and swept away houses that came in its way. There was neck-deep water in his friend's house. As his house was a pakka house, it was able to resist the strong winds which blew at a speed of 350 km per hour. His friend's family was terrorized because in the middle of the night, trees had fallen on the house, damaging the roof and walls of the building. So how horrible that storm was. The crazed destruction wrought by the cyclone and the surge of the ocean continued for the next 36 years. Although wind speeds had reduced somewhat by the next morning, to escape the waters rising in the house, Prashant and his friend's family had taken refuge on the roof. Prashant will never forget the shock he experienced at his first glimpse of the devastation wrought by the super cyclone. in the gray light of the early morning. So, the storm continued for the next 1.5 days. Although the wind had slowed down, to escape the rising levels of water, Prashant, along with his friend and his family, took shelter on the roof of the house. As the day dawned, Prashant saw the destruction caused by the super cyclone. A raging, deadly brown sheet of water covered everything as far as the eye could see only. Fractured cement houses still stood in a few places. Bloated means swollen animal carcasses meant dead bodies, and human corpses floated in every direction. All around, even huge old trees had fallen. Two coconut trees had fallen on the roof of their house. This was a blessing in disguise, because the tender coconuts from the trees kept the trapped family from starving in the several days that followed. Now, what happened next? As far as Prashant could see, he saw a cover of muddy brown water. There were the remaining of shattered houses surrounded by the water. Dead bodies of animals and human beings floated in the water. Huge trees had fallen and were floating around. Two coconut trees had fallen on the roof of their house. Initially, they thought that the trees had damaged the roof and walls of the house. But later, they realized that this proved to be beneficial for them. As they were trapped in the house, they ate the raw coconuts from these trees and saved themselves from dying due to starvation. For the next 2 days, Prashant had huddled with his friend's family in the open on the rooftop. They froze in the cold and incessant rain. Incessant means continuous rain. The rainwater washed away Prashant's tears. The only thought that flashed through his mind, was whether his family had survived the fury of the super cyclone. Was he to be bereaved once again? Why this thought came to his mind? Because he was in his friend's house, and his friend's house was 18 kilometers far from his house. So he was in his friend's house, and here in his friend's house, he was worried about his family. So they spent the next 2 days on the rooftop. Everyone was so scared that they sat together in a group. It was very cold, and the continuous rain washed away Prashant's tears. He was worried about his family members. Maybe he could have lost another family members and would be in grief over the loss of a loved one once again. This thought worried Prashant. 2 days later, which seemed to Prashant like 2 years, the rain ceased. Ceased means stopped. And the rainwater slowly began to recede. Recede means reduce. Prashant was determined to seek out his family without further delay. But the situation was still dangerous, and his friend's family pleaded with Prashant to stay back a little while longer. But Prashant knew he had to go. Now, the rain stopped after 2 days. It seemed to Prashant that the 2 days' time was as long as the duration of 2 years. This shows that it was very difficult for him to pass that time, as the worry about his family's well-being worried him. The rain had stopped and the water was receding gradually. Although it was dangerous to go out, he did not waste any more time and left to find his family. His friend's family requested Prashant to stay back, but he left. He equipped himself with a long, sturdy stick and then started on his 18-kilometer expedition back to his village through the swollen flood waters. It was a journey he would never forget. He constantly had to use his stick to locate the road to determine where the water was most shallow. At places, it was waist deep and progress was slow. At several points, he lost the road and had to swim. After some distance, he was relieved to find two friends of his uncle who were also returning to their village. They decided to move ahead together. Now, with the help of a long stick, Prashant See this picture. With the help of a long stick, Prashant started the 18-kilometer long journey back home. As he passed through the flood water, the journey got inscribed in his mind forever. He had to use the stick to guide him and find the path where the water was shallower. At some places, the water was waist deep and his pace slowed down. At some places, he lost a track of the road and had to swim to save himself from drowning. After some time, he was relieved as he got the company of two friends who, along with their uncle, were returning to their village. Now, all of them proceed together. As they waded through, waded means swam through the water, the scenes they witnessed grew more and more macabre, means horrible. They had to push away many human bodies, men, women, children, and carcasses of dogs. Carcasses means skeleton. And you can say dead bodies also. Carcasses of dogs, goats, and cattle that the current swept against them as they moved ahead. In every village they had that they passed, they could barely see a house standing. Prashant now wept out loud and long. He was sure that his family could not have survived this catastrophe. Catastrophe means disaster. Now, as the group proceeded, they got to see horrible scenes. They had to push dead bodies of human beings and animals which were being swept around with the current of the water. As they crossed villages, not even a single house was seen, all fallen down. As Prashant's fear grew, he wept loudly. He was sure that his family members would not have survived the disaster. Eventually, Prashant reached his village, Kalikuda. His heart went cold. Where their home once stood, there were only remnants. Remnants means remainings, small remainings of its roof. Some of their belongings were caught, mangled with, and twisted in the branches of trees, just visible above the dark waters. Young Prashant decided to go to the Red Cross shelter to look for his family. Now, when Prashant reached his village, Kalikuda, he became numb on seeing. Numb means quiet, just keep himself numb. On seeing the remains of his house, their belongings were scattered in the water and some things hung on branches of the trees just above the flood water. He decided to look for his family at the shelter set up by the Red Cross Society. Now, what next? Among the first people he saw the crowd was his maternal grandmother, weak with hunger. She rushed to him, her hands outstretched, her eyes brimming. Brimming means full of tears. It was a miracle. They had long given him up for dead. Now, what happened next? At the Red Cross shelter, he saw his maternal grandmother, means Nani. She appeared weak but was glad to see that Prashant was alive. She rushed to him with his arms open and her eyes full of tears. It was a miracle for her, as the family had thought that Prashant would not have survived the storm. Quickly, word spread and his extended family gathered around him and hugged him tight in relief. Prashant anxiously scanned the motley, battered group, his brother and sister, his uncles and aunts. They all seemed to be there. Battered means injured. Motley means dispirited. Grief. As Prashant's extended family came to know that he had come, they gathered around him and hugged him in relief. Prashant saw that everyone was worried and injured. He met his siblings, uncles, and aunts. So, this is from this we have completed the half chapter, reading and explanation of the half chapter. In the next video, we will cover the remaining part of the chapter. Till then, watch this video, read this chapter yourself to understand the lesson better. Thank you, class. Have a nice day.